Ladies and gentlemen, I enjoy a lot to be here with you to treat the subject that Ted asked me to present to you, Mediterranean Living, Model of Health and Longevity. First of all, what is the subject? What is Mediterranean diet? Here are the conclusions of a meeting in 2003 in Heraklion, in the mouth of Serge Renaud. One Mediterranean diet per se does not exist, since it is different and has different effects from country to country, even from region to region. Well, what is exactly Mediterranean diet, the diet that protects against cardiovascular disease? Let us take the example of France, in the Monica project. You see here the three towns of France in the Monica project. Toulouse is in south of France. Toulouse, because France has about a quarter of Mediterranean style. It doesn't impeach France to have still today the French paradox, that is to say the second lowest level of cardiovascular mortality in the world after the Japan. Even if there is a gradient north-south in, as Professor Corder showed us earlier, in average, France has a very low cardiovascular mortality level. And especially the south of France, for example, Toulouse, you see that the coronary heart disease premature death is very low, especially in the woman of Toulouse, is still lower than the Japanese woman, you see. Whereas Strasbourg and Lille are higher, despite that the fact that they are better than Stanford, Belfast, Glasgow, etc. It is a north-south gradient in Europe. Well, now, what do they eat in Toulouse? It is still the Monica project. You see that in Toulouse, they eat a lot of bread, more vegetable, more fruit, less butter, quite a lot of cheese, and more wine. Now, if we consider Europe and fruit and vegetables, that seems an important part of Mediterranean diet. You see that, in fact, here is a vegetable and fruits consumption. It is a slide of Serge Renaud. You see that the situation varies a lot between Yugoslavia, Spain, France, Italy, Greece. In fact, probably that vegetables and fruits are important, but it is not the only key factor in cardiovascular protection. And you see now in the European and with example of US situation in cardiovascular death rate, you see also some heterogeneity in what we can observe in the WHO data. In 95, you see that Greece is higher than Italy and Spain, and France is all the time the best. Even today, the last the available data, I believe that 2003 is available recently, but I did not look at. And you see that even Greece increase, it is one of the only Western developed countries that increase cardiovascular mortality. For some reason, they let the traditional diet, they smoke more, etc. Well, we continue. In fact, to approach what is Mediterranean diet, I propose to you to make an historic of the concept, of the modern concept, because Mediterranean diet was treated by Platon, by Hippocrates. But in the modern concept, in fact, it is a mix of three stories, three story connected the story of the seven country with the saturated fats, the cholesterol, the observation on Eskimo fish oil, fish omega 3, and the Cretan diet derived from seven country study. I tried to tell you the story as far as I know it. The modern concept of Mediterranean diet to prevent coronary heart disease and mortality started in Italy after the Second World War. Ansel Keys, you know probably Ansel Keys, and Paul Dudley White observed in the Napoli Hospital that the frequency of myocardial infarction was much lower than in Minneapolis hospitals. Ansel Keys was born in Minneapolis, and he went often to Italy. After he bought a house there, and finally he lived a very long time, you see, more than 100 years. And his wife too, because his wife worked with him and lived 97. And during his 100th birthday, journalists asked him whether his Mediterranean diet could explain his very long life, and he answered likely, but no proof on one case. He set up in the 50s a collaborative project, the Seven Country Study, to compare the diet in North Europe, South Europe, US, and Japan in the cardiovascular, the effect of diet on cardiovascular mortality and risk. On 12,000 subjects. And the first result of this very well-known study was that the main factor of coronary heart disease mortality could be the saturated fatty acid consumption. And you see a very beautiful relation, except that, for example, you see that Crete is out of the line. And this slide, in fact, led to a lot of research, intervention trials on decrease the saturated fatty acid, etc., and also question about the fact that you see that a lot of islands are in the bottom of the line: Crete, Corfu, Japan, and maybe it could be genetic factors, for example, in these islands. It led to the migrant population studies of Japanese to California, etc. And finally, it was not genetic, because you know that the Japan, as soon as they adopt the US diet, they have as much cardiovascular disease as American people. And in the diet of these seven country study, these countries, you see that one country, Crete, had the lowest cardiovascular mortality compared with the other Mediterranean cohort. You see 20 times less compared with the average, and almost 50 times less compared to US. Despite higher cholesterol level than the other cohorts, Mediterranean cohort. Alors, what do they eat in Crete? They eat, you see, a lot of bread compared to US, legumes, and a lot of fruits, you see, 464 grams a day of fruits. A few fish, a moderate consumption of fish and meat, and a lot of olive oil, almost 100 grams a day, and a moderate consumption of alcohol. But as the cholesterol was higher, here is the conclusion of Blackburn after the first result of seven country studies. Enfin, it is a summary. The Cretan cohort had the lowest mortality from coronary heart disease and all cause. Their longevity could be due to the exceptional climate, absence of stress and pollution, siesta or other factors yet to be discovered, rather to the poor people diet they use. Alors, the question was saturated fat, is it the main environmental factor for coronary heart disease? A lot of randomized trials were done in the 80s to verify this hypothesis, and the results were very disappointing in secondary prevention. After they made a big trial in primary prevention in psychiatric hospitals, the famous Minnesota coronary survey, and they decreased, you see, the saturated fat by 50%. They decreased also the cholesterol, but surprisingly enough, they increased not significantly the coronary events and the all-cause mortality. At this time, in the end, you see, of the 80s, nobody believed to nutrition, in fact, because this result was so surprising. And even here is a meta-analysis of all the dietary fat intake and prevention of cardiovascular disease, and you see that the results is very disappointing. Nothing on total mortality, nothing on cardiovascular mortality, a little effect on cardiovascular events. Well, and more recently, but it is related to what I should do, because this study is the greatest international study ever made. Probably that the design was made minimum 20 years ago, taking in account the duration of the follow-up and the number of women, you see almost 50,000. And they decreased by 50% the consumption of fat without to pay attention to the quality of the fat. And the result is nothing, no results, no effect, neither on cardiovascular disease, nor on cancer, nor on obesity, you see. You see the price of the study, I did not write it, but half a billion of dollars. And this study, despite the negative results, is very interesting, because it shows that the low-fat diet is not the solution. You see that Cretan people, 100 grams of olive oil a day. Alors, here, do you recognize this man? During all this time, the seven country study, Serge Renaud worked on platelet aggregation. And here is in his laboratory in Montreal. And to summarize 20 years of his work, platelet reactivity is influenced by some of the main risk factors of coronary heart disease, saturated fats, ALA, alors we will speak about ALA, alpha-linolenic acid, omega-3, alcohol and polyphenol, calcium, smoking, age, hormones. A lot of papers about all these subjects. And particularly this one, small is beautiful, about alpha-linolenic with striking change in platelet behavior, etc. And remind about what is the main dietary fatty acid. The saturated fatty acid, the monounsaturated, majoritary in olive oil and rapeseed oil, and the polyunsaturated, you have the omega-6 with linoleic acid, majoritary in soybean oil, and alpha-linolenic acid present in rapeseed oil and also in soybean oil. And the long chain fatty acid, omega-3 fatty acid present in fish, EPA and DHA. We will speak about this family, omega-3, with the precursor present in vegetal precursor, but present also in fish, and the elongated fatty acid. You see, alpha-linolenic is C18-3 or N-3 or omega-3 because the first double bind is at the three at the extremity of the molecule at the third carbon, whereas omega-6 begins, the first double bind begins here. And human is not able to introduce double bind in this area. That is why these two families, 3 and 5, are called essential fatty acids, as vitamins. Alors, in fact, we arrived to the Cretan diet history and the lion study, because during this time, they realized, Catan, it is a paper of the Catan team, they realized that Cretan cohort had three times more linolenic acid compared to, for example, Dutch cohort, three times. And it was quite surprising because in olive oil, you see in oil, white is omega-3 alpha-linolenic. In olive oil, you have less than 0.5% of omega-3. And if Cretan cohort had so much alpha-linolenic in the plasma, it came from diet because it is an essential fatty acid that human is not able to synthesize. Well, we come back to the diet of the Cretan cohort. You see that they eat a lot of vegetables. From what food comes this high level, three times level of alpha-linolenic in the blood? We participate to the 40 years of the 7 country study, Serge Renaud and me, with the dietitian Frosso Bervanacki to interview the survivors of the Cretan cohort. And we tried to find the specificity of the from what food comes this alpha-linolenic acid. And petit à petit, alors we made an artisanal study, not published, but we tried to interview the old subject about what they ate in the past. It is quite, it is not something very acceptable from the scientific point of view, but we spent quite a lot of time with every subject and family one day to try to that they remember what they eat in the past with the Cretan dietitian. And here is the kind of, it is a frequency, food frequency questionnaire, but the kind of diet that they ate. Because we suppose that in the 7 country study, American, even if they made a lot of analysis on the food, they did not take in account the seasonal aspects of some foods as white greens, etc. And in fact, you see that what characterizes the diet of Cretan traditional people, traditional diet, it is a lot of fruit, 1 to 5 a day. Wine, alors it depends on, it was on 7 people. You see, we cannot make statistics, but it gives you an idea. Every day, bread, olive oil, cheese, goat cheese, milk, goat every day, every morning, in fact, early in the morning, 200 milliliters. Eggs, quite a lot of eggs. Legumes, vegetables, white greens. Alors, we made with the dietitian an average on the year. During the season, it is every day white greens. Purslane is one of the white grains that you can find everywhere in Crete. Very rich in alpha-linolenic acid. Meat, a few meats, generally in the weekend. And because every family had his own pork, and surprisingly enough, the woman in Crete they cooked with pork fat from Christmas to Easter. But this pork is very well nourished, you imagine, and he concentrates to a lot. It is an average on the year. Hein, that you know. Donc, the fat of the pork is very well balanced. Fish, very few fish, because the Cretan cohort lives far from the coast, maybe 20 miles. And in fact, it is salted fish and only two times a month. And snails very often, especially during the fasting. We will see that there is a lot of fasting in the Cretan diet. They eat every day because they consider as no, it is no meat. But these snails, nourished with wild grains, very rich in omega-3, as Serge Renaud measured. And some specialty rich also in omega, I have no time to develop too much, and yogurt, walnuts. Okay. Here is a purslane, you see, and snails. And here is a kind of diet that they offer to us. We ask us them to make something traditional. You see here is the wild greens, here too, and the snails under different form. It is a homemade bread, wool meal, and some eggs in the salad. Here is a traditional Cretan diet. And here is a cereals in goat milk, dried and after used to make a soup. Here is a subject of the Cretan cohort, 95 years, you see. They look fine. you want to see again? And alors, at this time, Servino considered that if Cretan people had so few coronary heart events, probably they must have a diet rich in alpha-linolenic, in fact, because the publication of Catan were not yet published, and he understood that. And he set up a diet directly inspired from the Cretan diet, with more bread, more vegetable, more fish. More fish, it was not clear at this time. Less meat, no day without fruit, no more butter and cream replaced by the supplied margarine. This margarine, you see, where is it? Rapeseed margarine is very close to rapeseed oil, in fact. With 5% of trans, but France is a problem in quantity. Alors, the intake of food, because between what we advise to the patient and what they do, really, you see, there is sometimes a gap. Alors, what they did, you see, they ate more bread, more fruit, 41 grams, less meat, and they replaced butter by margarine, and no more fish. You see, and it was after the result of the Lyon study, it was also a problem because Servano wanted to give himself the maximum chance to have a result, and that is why he changed some parameters. But finally, the principal parameter were this, you see, because even 41 grams of fruits. I don't think that it could explain the huge results of the Lyon study. Alors, what you can see in the results of the Lyon studies, it is that diet protects rapidly against cardiovascular events. You see, it is like an aspirin effect. It is a platelet effect. And here, to remind you for those who do not know yet the Lyon study, with only plus 1.2 grams of alpha-linolenic acid, you see that the results, especially on sudden death, 10 against 0 in two groups of 300. Hein? And the total cardiovascular events, 70 against 14. Very significant, and the ethical committee decided to stop the study. You see that the lipemia, don't look at the detail, believe me, did not move. All the lipid parameters did not move at 8 weeks or at 1 year. That is why the paper of Sarah was refused by New England Journal of Medicine, because they said it is not possible because the cholesterol did not move. And after, they presented the paper to the Lancet, and the Lancet did something else. Because the initial title was Cretan Mediterranean Diet, they did not like it. Because Cretan, I suppose that Cretan in English sounds a little maybe pejorative. Alors they changed the title. And it is one of the reasons of the confusion today about Mediterranean diet. Because after I spent 12 years of my life in a food company to make research, nutritional research, and I remember that at this time the marketing takes this concept Mediterranean diet, and everybody wanted to make Mediterranean diet, tomato sauce, pasta, olive oil, etc. You see, that is some confusion remains still today about what is Mediterranean diet. In his second paper, Serge Renaud maintained his initial title, Cretan Mediterranean diet, because you saw that Cretan is very different compared to the other Mediterranean areas. Maybe if the seven countries study had a cohort in Sardinia, they would have found some interesting results too, because it is the same kind of diet. And you see that in the experimental group, the alpha linolenic doubled compared to the control. And all the we have no time to analyze all the details. But what was new, not planified, it is the effect on sudden death and cardiac rhythm. And it opened at the same time. I told you that there are some studies interconnected. The omega-3 study, the fish study with Bang and Dyerberg, who observed the Eskimo and the effect of fish on heart, on sudden death and cardiac death, with the experiment of McLennan on rats, and on after the DART intervention trial with fish opened new horizon, and the lion study, and after Alexander Leaf explained the electrophysiology of the mechanisms of omega-3 on arrhythmia, the Gissi trial, and after Singh confirms the Renault study with the ectopics, the effects on the ectopics, and some observations were made on population, protected population as Inuit, and they found always this high level on alpha-linolenic EPA, DHA, compared to, for example, Vancouver, you see, four times level. This story of omega-3 seems to be an important part of Mediterranean or Cretan diet, even in comparison. You see here Japanese people compared to Lyon cohort with 21, because it is a question of analysis. You see that the Lyon cohort has had really a high level compared to this protected population, owing to the diet rich in rapeseed oil and margarine, rapeseed margarine. Because it, I advance. You remember the two family, N-6, N-3, they compete for the same enzyme system. That is why the balancing both is very important, because the N-3 gives prostanoid, leucotriene, prostaglandine, with anti-inflammatory effect, aggregator, not anti-aggregator, but very low aggregant effect, anti-arrhythmic effect, vasodilator effect, whereas the N-6 family gives the opposite. That is not to say that N-6 is bad and N-3 good. It is a question of ratio between the two families. At the moment, in Western countries, there is too much N-6 and not enough N-3 because of the offer of the oil, oil only oil rich in N-6, and the food chain, the feeding of the animals, all the food chain is appauvrished in omega-3. Bon, I run because it is. Alors, the effects of N-3 on my sites, there are some explanations as an inhibitory calcic effects, action of connexin, because the cells communicate in the heart by connexin, and these fatty acids take part in the structure of the channel, some different kind of channel. In fact, it is very complicated, and a lot of research is made on that. And to finish this subject of omega-3 and alpha-linolenic, how to make sure to get daily 2 grams of alpha-linolenic? It is enough to use daily 2 spoons of rapeseed oil or margarine for cooking and dressing, possibly mixed with olive oil, or as Cretan traditional dwellers, 300 grams of wild greens, even cabbage, for example. In cabbage, you have 400 milligrams per 100 grams of alpha-linolenic, and choose animals fed with wild greens as gibier, gibier, I don't know in English, gibier, wild animals, milk, cheese, and eggs of these animals, snail, etc. Alors, to come back to the Lion study, not only the cardiovascular events were prevented, but also the cancer. Even if the design of the study were not made to study the cancer, there is a cancer effect could be observed. And another story about the 7-country study is a Finland study, because Finland, you see, was the highest in coronary mortality. And they made a very beautiful national program of prevention with Pekka Puska. And they changed really their dietary habits. They reduce saturated fat. They use low fat milk. And they were lucky because they did not know at this time that rapeseed oil were good for heart, and it is the only plant that can grow in Finland because it is a cold country, and the omega-3 allows the plant to adapt to the cold because the polyunsaturates are more resistant to the cold. You see, if you put an oil in the refrigerator, compare rapeseed with olive oil, for example. It is rapeseed oil is widely used today in Finland in the last 30 years, including in the margarine industry. And fruit consumption has doubled and vegetables almost tripled in 20 years. You see, Finland compared to Karelia, South Karelia and Estonia in using of butter and in using consuming fresh vegetables, you see Finland compared to Estonia and South Karelia. And here is an example of the effort that they make in Finland. You see, it is to elevate vegetables and fruits. And the results is quite impressive, not only on cancer, and on coronary heart disease, you see, until 2000, it continued to decrease. And what is quite surprising is that a part of this decrease remains unexplained by the classical correction of the by the correction of the classical risk factors, as cholesterol, smoking, blood pressure, etc. And it could be possible that this unexplained part could be due to the large use of rapeseed oil and these providing of omega-3. And you see here is a transfer study in, you see that Finland, here is the alpha-linolenic, has almost 2 grams a day of alpha-linolenic. And the ratio under 5, that is a recommendation, whereas some country, as you see here, the ratio omega, it is not exactly, but almost omega 6 on omega 3, because EPA, DHA are in small quantities. You see the case of Spain, because Spain, rapeseed is forbidden for reasons that could be too long to tell you. Alors, they have only olive oil and sunflower oil in the country. And you see the result. The result is a ratio 27. And you see that Finland is in the good way. Other trails today on this Mediterranean diet, it is the relation between wine and omega-3. I am not going to develop that, but there are new interesting papers the last month or year considering that maybe there is synergy between wine polyphenols and omega-3. Polyphenol could protect the omega-3 of the blood. And finally, to give an increase of the level of omega-3 in the blood. Here is a work of Federico Leighton, very interesting. And here is a work made from the data of Serge Renaud in the Lyon study, and a new study, European study. Enfin, it is an affair to follow, and further clinical study would be required. Now, I would like to say a word about fasting, because it is an unknown aspect of the Cretan diet. In fact, if you consider the way of life of Cretan Orthodox, they are almost all Orthodox, Christian Orthodox, they fast 40 days before Christmas, 40 days before Palm Sunday, and 1 week before Easter. Depending on the calendar, on the 8 days to 6 weeks after Pentecost, and 2 weeks in August, the first, and in addition, every Wednesday and Friday all the year. You see that if you addition everything, you have over half the year at some level of strictness for an Orthodox Christian. And there are some paper, but a little study at the moment, but I think that this is something interesting. From the Anthony Skiafatos team, they observe groups of, they compare Orthodox with non-Orthodox, and they found differences in lipid parameters, obesity, etc. And this regulation of religion lead to decrease saturated fat, increase the fibers, folate, and increase the fruits, vegetables, and legumes. Conclusion. Enfin, you see, it is not very academic, because what I present you, it is not something presented by American Heart Association, or it is the results of crossing different studies and different. What is exactly the protective Mediterranean diet that could be observed in Crete? Finally, you have some elements. 2 grams a day of alpha-linolenic acid from white greens, food chain, that can be obtained from canola, because we cannot find everywhere the snails of Crete and the goat cheese of Crete, etc. Low in saturated fatty acid and low in omega-6. A lot of fruits, 450 grams a day, a moderate wine consumption, fasting often, and I forgot to tell you that the physical activity is very high in this cohort. They explained us that they made almost every day something like 20 miles walking, etc. A lot of physical activity, resulting in a quite high level of calories intake, about 3,500 for men. Voilà, thank you very much.